I went down a rabbit hole. 32-bit float versus 24-bit linear audio recordings for dialogue in particular. Is there a difference? I watched a podcast by Chris Monroe, was one of the production mixers that was on it, and he said that 32-bit float offers you the ability to clean up the audio better than 24-bit float, or 24-bit linear, excuse me. And so I did some tests. I did some recordings with some kind of steady state noise, a fan basically in the background while I was talking, and also with some ringtones, so some non-steady state noise, and tried to clean those up in Isotope RX, and they both cleaned up nicely. So I didn't see an advantage for 32-bit float. Then I went and did a bunch of research, and one of the concerns that I've always mentioned with potential concerns with 32-bit float is taking audio from a high amplitude and a low amplitude converter and bringing them back together. You know, as the amplitude changes in your recording, which it is doing constantly, isn't there some sort of artifacting that happens there as it has to make the switch from one to the other? And the answer is in this particular article, which I'll link to in the description, they tested the Zoom, the little audio interface. It's like a $200 or maybe it's a less than $300 audio interface, fairly inexpensive. So they were able to detect when the audio was switching from the high to the low amplitude, but the impact to the recording was so minute that it was basically not something you could detect by ear. That lines up with my experience. So in short, 32-bit float on a well-implemented version of 32-bit float on a recorder or audio interface or whatever it is, no real cost from what we can see from an audio perspective.